The last thing that I would like to demo for the basic brush settings is the brush tip shape, and you can access that via the brush panel like we have used for the other act demos. If you grab the brush tool and then you access the brush panel either through the option menu, or I'm going to undock the brush panel over here, you can change the brush tip shape by selecting brush tip shape on the panel, and then you can click through. And I think the best way to see what these do is just to select a brush and then start painting, and you can see the difference in what is created based on the brush that you have selected. And so each brush is going to kind of by default be different or slightly different depending on which one you choose, and they can be bigger or smaller, they can have softer edges or harder edges. If you want to, you can experiment with making more adjustments to your shape. And so I think it was, let's try this one. So this one, as I drag it, you can kind of see that it's being made from a bunch of little shapes. And maybe I don't want it to be continuous like this, but I kind of like the texture that it's creating. If you select a brush on the brush panel and then you adjust the other settings, like shape dynamics, scattering, texture, dual brush, or even spacing down here, which is the first thing I'm going to do, you can take a default brush and kind of make it your own. And so you can space these out further to see what the texture that is creating that shape is. You can see there are little rectangles here. And so now when you paint with this brush, you can see that it's going to space out how close they are. Maybe that's still not the look you're going for, so you come back and you bring it closer together. You can choose to add wet edges to something, which usually creates a cool effect. You can do color dynamics, so you can have a hue jitter. And you can increase or decrease the amount of color that's applied when you are using your brush. And can you see, I'll do it down here. As I paint, it's going to change the color of the brush because I added a hue jitter. We're not going to go through all the different settings that are on the brush panel, but you should know how to access the brush panel. And you should know that it's fun to play around with those options, and you should kind of click through and experiment and see what they do.